Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy. An interesting project. I am rebuilding a standard B. I've just removed the mainspring. There was a major problem with this machine, which is pretty common to standards. It has a phenolic gear on the spindle, which mates with a worm gear on the governor. And on many occasions, the only thing that's holding this gear on is friction. It's a press fit with one little key slot. And you can see that right there. Littlest, tiniest key slot. And as this gear begins to wear, it will sometimes jump on top of that key sticking out. The key will then be under it, and as it rotates, it wobbles, which really affects the speed, makes the machine sound absolutely terrible. So that's what had happened to this one. So I've removed it, cleaned it with alcohol, and then epoxied it in place. And the nice thing about epoxies, which most people don't realize, is the quick setting epoxy, 90 second epoxy and 5 minute epoxy, will not hold with heat. So if you ever want to get these epoxy joints apart again, all you have to do is just zap this steel with a little pencil torch, or if you shield this phenolic gear, you can actually hold it over a flame. The epoxy releases, you can pull it right off. Quick set epoxy is very sensitive to heat. Most of it you can take off with a heat gun. In any case, I've got the motor disassembled. This is a standard pillar and plate motor, pillar and plate motor, yeah. And it definitely shows some wear. Standard machine, of course, has a two-weight governor, which is it wasn't super effective when it was new, let alone 100 years later. But I'll have this machine up running in an hour or so, and then we'll put it back together and see how it works, and I'll follow up then. Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy. I have reassembled the motor on the standard Model B. It was a difficult spring to put back in the spring barrel. This was a really tough motor to rebuild. That spring is really, really stout, and it goes into a very, very small spring barrel. So if you do happen to disassemble your Model B, be prepared for a fight to get the spring back in the spring barrel. It was difficult, to say the least. In any case, the machine is up and running. I've tuned it. It runs well. I have repaired the tone arm. This was a solder joint that had broken. I repaired that with epoxy. Also, I have installed a Columbia reproducer. Now, the end of the tone arm had a shroud, and all that structure was gone. It originally had a detent, a spring-loaded detent that held the reproducer in position. However, since that structure is gone, it left a hole where the detent used to be. So I've simply tapped that hole, 832, cut off a screw, and installed an 832 screw. So you just slide the reproducer into position, tighten the screw, and you're up and running. In any case, I'm going to play the standard Model B. This is a modified Brunswick record. It allows me to tune the machine, check the reproducer, using a good quality recording. In any case, this is the standard Model B.
The sun has gone.
Standard Model B is up and running. Still have a lot of adjustments to do on it, but at least the motor is running. I have a lot of cleanup and some cabinet work to do, but 3 days ago this machine was an absolute wreck. So I've accomplished something today in any case. If you have any questions about the Standard Model B, if you need any pointers on getting that spring back in that barrel, and trust me, it is a bear. It is difficult to do. So if you have any questions on the Standard Model B or any of the machines that I've covered in my series, feel free to drop me a line. The Victrola Guy at victortalkingmachines@gmail.com. So if you do have any questions, feel free to contact me direct. I answer all my email and more than happy to help. The Victrola Guy at victortalkingmachines@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.